Yajnashishta, Shishta Shishta, Deva Shishta. Whatever prasad we are getting from the temple, that is known as Deva Shishta. Whatever the remains and residues of our rituals, that is Yajnashishta. Whatever the remains of the divine people in their planted leaves, that is known as Shishta Shishta, they are Shishta. And that remains are known as Shishta Shishta. And we believe that more than 10 years of education, whatever the knowledge you can derive, by 10 grains or morsels of food that you are taking properly from the Deva, a Rajna or a Shishta, that can give you equal benefit. So our Annaprashana not only considers Anna as a channel for the supplying of biological nutrition and making us sturdy, healthy and muscle building, all of these things are not there. Spiritual way of considering food as a channel for divine communication, a divine intellectual transmission. You can transmit your knowledge, Rukveda you can transmit through food. That is known as our Annaprashana. And here we are having a nadi. There are three nadis, you must have observed here. So for some people it may be visible. In the direct, in this Dakshana and Vamakarna, it is known as Agra. It is known as Agra. It is known as Shika. It is known as Bila. It is known as Upabila. It is known as Dwara. It is known as Sandhi. It is known as Guha. And there is a Rajju. And there is a Medha, Rajju Medha. And there is a Dhanda. These are all the components of our ear. And this is known as Prathama Varana. This is known as Shiki. It is known as Makari. These are all the components of ear. And in this particular area, beneath this Shika, we are having three nadis. One is Grahadi, second is Dharani, third thing is Yojani. Otherwise known as Yogini also. This Grahani gives you attention. This Dharani gives you retention. This Yogini gives you application. Whenever you want to reproduce, you have to reproduce. So, according to us, according to general scientific view, according to general common view, this is just an audition tool. It can hear, but it can also support attention, retention, and whenever possible or whenever wanted, reproduction also. It is Grahana, Dharana, Milana, Sankalana, Vachana, Pravachana, Prayoga. If you can say it back, Vachana. If you can elaborate it, that is Pravachana. If you can demonstrate it, that is Prayoga. So all of these possibilities are Grahana, Dharana and Prayoga. These Shaktis are there and the deities governing or the nadis governing, they are known as Grahani, Dharani and Yogini or Yojani. So whenever there is a ceremonial piercing, now they are saying that piercing is good, piercing is good, but whatever the thing that we do with mantra, samantra, amantra, sabija, abija, sadravya, adravya, sabhava, abhava, we have to make a tabulation. Making the same thing with mantras, without mantras. Making the same thing with bhava, with real belief, with submission, and doing without belief and submission. With the dravyas, essential dravyas. Piercing it with anything else, like with a safety pin, you can pierce somebody. You can do it with anything. But upadhana, muhurta, mantra, vidhi, paddhati, prakriya, krama, we are having some rules and regulations. Doing the same thing with the rules and regulations, it gives divine benefits. So now they have identified that piercing this place, that makes the person to, that's why even, so you know that while lifting the rabbits, they used to lift the rabbits with the ears. Something is lifted with the tails, something is lifted with the back, something with the forelegs, something with the back legs. Like that, whenever a teacher, for the non-attentive, or for a drowsy child, a non-studious student, they used to always pinch the ears. Not ears, just pinch. But now even it is not allowed now. If they pinch, they will be punched and sent back. And there is no possibility for piercing. Even pinching is impossible. What I want to say is, whenever you do, we are normally a deed, which is known as Kriya. I want to say, Kriya gives you 25% benefit. If it is done with the Dravya also, that gives you 50% benefit. If the same thing is done with the Mantra also, that gives 75% benefit. If it is done with the Kriya, embedded with the Dravya, embedded also, embellished with the Mantra also, with fullest Bhava, that gives you consummate benefit. So our system is a well-civilized system, so that it gives the utmost benefits by including all the four pillars for the successful completion of the deed or the samskara, that is Karnavedi. By punching this area, what we get is, immediately, each and everything, if you operate a system, a remote system, you know that the similar operations are handled in the device, like volume, contrast, on, off, everything is done there also. Likewise, in the Dharakasha, inside there is an endoetheric reticulum. It is known as endoetheric reticulum. in scientific language, which we call as Dharakasha, Chidakasha or Pindakasha. That subtle ether has these type of qualities known as Grahana, Dharana, Sankalana, etc. Whenever by mantras and bhavas it is pierced inside, the valves inside for more Grahana, Dharana and Milana are this type of Prayogana. All of these valves are opened by which a person's ability to attend, ability to return and ability to reproduce, that gets more productively intensified, so that it is very much essential for all people to do that. So piercing this here, that creates immediately a type of thing here which is known as a cerebral reflection. There are three things: mastishka, mana, mantra, bhava. Our bhava, whatever we worship, they create three impacts. One is mastishka impact, second is mana impact, third thing is mantra impact. Whatever the mantras that we chant, they penetrate as neurosignal transmitters. They penetrate as neurosignal transmitters and reaches the visible area. There are two areas of mental operations. The visible area is known as neuropsychiatry. The study is known as neuropsychiatry, and there is a brain area. And the subtle area is known as the mind. This mantra, it balances in such a manner that it reaches the mind from one end and reaches the mastishka, the brain, from the one end. So ability to learn more, which is in science known as synaptic pruning. Synaptic pruning is the ability of a child to get more knowledge, disintegrate everything and concentrating the same thing as micronutrients and reservation of the same and reproducing it whenever wherever required. This capability is known as synaptic pruning. If a person can make synaptic pruning, the whole book can be very easily accommodated in a small space. Like the tip of a hair can accommodate Britannica, Encyclopedia Britannica. The whole 10 or 20 volumes of Encyclopedia Britannica can be very easily, comfortably accommodated. Accommodation means not just holding, reproducing it whenever, wherever needed. That type of knowledge is known as, the ability of brain is known as synaptic pruning. By Karnavedi, this type of synaptic pruning is induced. Already it is there in all living beings. Already all living beings, to their need and to their circumstantial applications, even a dog has its own synaptic pruning that is needed for its circumstances. But we will get some sort of an additive inducer which may make our synaptic pruning more comfortably accommodated inside, more realized and relished. Whatever we study now, there are two problems I always used to say in education. Realization and relishing or rejection is not there in education. It serves as a burden and it is serving as a punishment for all students, lecturers or teachers or anybody who is dealing with the academic work. So knowledge becomes more realizable and relishable when it is done through our Vedic Shastric methods. So this Karnavedha is very much essential. And Surakarna, you know that this place, it is having a small hole. That hole, see, there are three special anatomies. One is psychoanatomy of body, second is microanatomy of body, and the third thing is milli anatomy of body and nano or subtle anatomy of your body. Apart from this body, which we measure through various other enzymes, cells, tissues, DNA, genes, etc., we are having shat chakras. Lot of varmasthanas. If you go to Tanvology, they say that there are lot of varmasthanas in the form of santi and granthis, junctions and knots. We are having innumerable varmasthanas which are not read in that conventional anatomy. So that is say a type of subtle anatomy. And acupressure and acupuncture also, they are having lot of points which are not graspable, which are not intelligible by modern economical studies. This anatomical studies. So there is microanatomy and there is nanoanatomy, there is subtle anatomical study, wherein by we can understand the real structure of our body and understand the nuances or mysteries hidden inside. There they call that Brahmarandha. There is a dwara here, Sahasratala Padma, or it is known as the Sahasrara Chakra in Yoga Shastra. And it is a small dwara. Dwara means it is not a hole for a rat or any ant. It is the subtlest hole which is permissible only to the osmotic pressure of an entry of your soul at the time of Garbhadana, departure of the soul at the time of Nishkramana or Antyakti. And at any other time, nobody can enter inside, and it is perfectly a single entry route, only meant for a single entity. It is also a single entry, also a single entity route, which is only meant for the soul. This Brahmarandra is having a Sheetra.